Welcome back to Geeks R Sexy. I'm Jason LeDuc, your host on the fourth Friday of every month when Michelle Davis is off doing other things. And we're talking about business and success here in Las Vegas. Our next guest is Dwayne Davison from Entertainment Capital Group. Another born and raised Las Vegan, two in a row on the show this week. Dwayne started out in a career in finance and ended up shifting gears into a number of entrepreneurial ventures. You've always got something going on.
Yes, sir.
Known you for a couple of years now, and you've always got something fun going on. But his passion is the entertainment business. So welcome to the show, Dwayne. Thanks for being here.
Thank you for having me.
And tell us about growing up here in Las Vegas and what kind of role entertainment played in your life growing up here in Las Vegas.
Well, as you know, we're in the entertainment capital of the world. You know, so even at an early age, you're used to seeing and hearing about all the concerts and different events coming in town. And I can remember being 5 years old going to my first concert. I think it was MC Hammer, Boyz II Men, and Jodeci.
That is a great lineup, and that is not a lineup you get to see very often anymore together.
Not so. Right now, unfortunately.
No, that'd be a good lineup, though. You should think about that.
I already have. So started there and then just on and on. My father in the 90s, he owned an entertainment company that gave me a little inspiration. He also owned a few service businesses in town. So it gave me a little motivation, showed me that it can be done.
Yeah, so not just a passion for entertainment, but a family history of entrepreneurship and,
yes, sir.
And having a couple different ventures going on at the same time and really pursuing those different passions and trying to get them to work together. That's great. So grew up here in Las Vegas.
Yes.
UNLV grad.
Yes,
sir. Just like myself. And and you studied and went into a career in finance.
Yes, I studied management economics at UNLV. Prior to that, I actually studied finance in high school, at Clark High School.
Okay, cool.
You know, so that kind of got me used to the different elements of putting a business together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, marketing, accounting, you know, employees. Entertainment was never discussed there, but it was still definitely part of the passion. So from there, graduated from UNLV. Luckily, was working at Wells Fargo in a banking job in management.
Mm-hmm.
And just by the grace, I landed in the entertainment business. I met an artist who was looking for management. I figured, hey, I just graduated with a management degree. Mm-hmm. I love entertainment. Let's give it a shot. And 8 years later, you know, we're still here doing live events. No more artist management because that gets very expensive.
Yeah. Artist management is not only is expensive, it's time-consuming. And it takes a lot of energy and... A lot of energy and devotion, I think, is probably the right way to put it. Is you've really got to be completely devoted to the artists you're managing, and
they have to be devoted as well.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So talk about that.
Well, as an artist, much like an athlete, you have to believe in yourself more than anyone else. If you don't believe you're going to be successful, like an entrepreneur as well, then you're not going to be successful. And so, if you're an aspiring artist manager, make sure you manage artists who believe in themselves and invest in themselves as well.
Okay, great.
Great. For sure.
So, I know you've got a vision because we've talked before. We've known each other for a few years now. You've got a vision for the kind of entertainment you'd like to see happening
yes.
in Las Vegas. You've got a vision for how to bring that about. Tell us about your vision for entertainment in Las Vegas and your role in bringing that vision to life.
Well, a vision that I came up with years ago is once-in-a-lifetime entertainment. You know, we can go to a Cirque show any Thursday night in Vegas or any Friday night.
Any night.
And you can go to any country concert, but you're really looking for shows that you can't see ever again. You know, so
right.
we're doing once-in-a-lifetime events that, and that kind of creates a buzz. It creates a demand mm-hmm. for your client to say, hey, I can't go see this same show in Phoenix next weekend. You know, or
right.
the way with concerts now, you do a show every day in the same market. So if there's a huge fan, you can follow your artists all around the area and catch the same show. So my idea is to make you come out and see a show you've never seen before and you may never see it again. For example, my first show I did a show with two rappers from Houston who hadn't performed together in 10 years.
Oh, wow.
And they were friends and they had a falling out because of business. Mm-hmm. And I got them on stage for the first time in 10 years and actually made up at that event. So no one there has ever seen them perform before.
So if you can't talk about this, that's okay. But how did you get those two to come together? What I mean, that's a significant task to get
yes.
two people, both strong personalities, I
yes.
assume. You know, you just talked about the devotion, having to believe that you are better than anyone else to
yes.
be an artist. How did you get the two of them to come together?
Well, I paid them first.
Okay. Always helpful.
You pay them, and it just took a whole bunch of negotiation, and I let them know that this is for the fans. And the fans were
okay.
requesting this type of event in Las Vegas. These were guys who hadn't performed in Vegas in years. You know, very old Houston rappers, and mm-hmm. it was a great success. And they had a chance to talk about their grievances, and I haven't seen them on a show since. I'm not saying it hasn't happened, but I haven't seen the show in 2 years since that show.
So this is the vision, is providing these unique entertainment events, these once-in-a-lifetime events.
Yes, sir.
In a once-in-a-lifetime location in Las Vegas. Mm-hmm. What are the venues you like to use here in Las Vegas? What kind of venue is great here for those once-in-a-lifetime events?
Well, you really want a nice intimate venue. You know, the large events, they're great for the huge megastars, but you can catch them anywhere. So I prefer to work with venues from 1,000 people up to 3,000 people.
Okay.
So we're speaking of the Fremont Country Club.
Okay.
Brooklyn Bowl, House of Blues. Mm-hmm. Even Cox Pavilion at UNLV is a perfect venue for an intimate show.
Yeah, Cox Pavilion is actually a great venue. It feels a lot more intimate than it really is. I think it's a big space, but it feels small.
I have plans to work over at the Chelsea and Park Theater as well.
Oh, I love the Chelsea. Yeah. That's a great venue as well. All right, so we talked a little about the acts. We talked a little about the venue. What makes a great event? What are the things you need to pull together to make a great event for your fans for these once-in-a-lifetime experiences?
Well, it takes the fan. You know, first of all, you know, we have to have demand in any business. We have to have generate that demand. Then it's the artist. You know, you have to have artists that people actually care about. That's a good person. You know, when it comes to business ethics and morals, it's all about doing great business with people that you actually support.
For sure.
So the fan, the artist, the great venue, and then the production. And the production is everything you see and you don't see. So you will see production can include marketing.
Mm-hmm.
It include going to get a certain type of bottle of water.
Yeah,
and everything in between.
That's the stuff that I think is most interesting, right? Because we've all been to a show.
Yeah.
We know it makes a great show on the front end, and we know what. But what are some of those things in the back end that we don't see that make those events great?
You don't see the negotiation to bring guys together.
Yeah. Right?
You know, you don't see the airport runs. You don't see the coordination with security. You don't see the payments to the police department for their protection.
Okay.
You know, you don't see the taxes that you have to pay after your show. You know, you don't see the worry of the risk as well.
I imagine there's a lot of dealing with the artists, people, and their entourage and that kind of thing as well.
Yeah, and luckily I have a team as well. And so when we have events, I have a team that steps in. They help me deal with those different personalities because we can't do it all.
Yeah. And that's so important. We talk about it on this show. Scott can vouch for this. I think we talk about this on this show every month when we do it. Is nobody does these things alone. You have to have a great team. Behind you and in front of you, supporting you, and you need to support them to pull off any big goal that you want to pull off in life. So in the couple of minutes we've got left, tell us the kind of people you're looking for to be on your team.
Local promoters. You know, you have a great outreach to the fans, the core client from every demographic. We're looking for the fan, you know, local entertainment lovers, from country music lovers to comedy to hip-hop and R&B. And then we're also looking for the network. You know, use your network, use my network, and it helps grow all of our net worth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so I'm just looking to work with local entrepreneurs who are looking to grow their business as well and reach a demographic they haven't reached before.
All right. Sounds great. So
yes, sir.
What's your favorite kind of show to put on?
Favorite? We'll say hip-hop and R&B. I was raised on hip-hop and R&B, but I love a good laugh.
Okay.
So I love a good comedy show.
I know you're always looking for how to put together a great comedy show.
Yes.
That was one of the first things you and I talked about a couple years ago when we met, is you were looking to do more of those comedy shows. And I think that was the very first show that you were, since I met you, that was the next thing you had coming up was a big comedy show.
So we're working right now. We're going to merge the two. So we're going to merge comedy and music.
Okay.
You know, working on having.
Love it. Love it.
Maybe
more of that.
I'll tell you more about that offline. But we're working on that as well.
Absolutely. Well, we've only got a minute left, but I want you to tell our audience how they can get a hold of you, whether they are an act, an entertainer, who they might want to connect with you, or someone who could fit into your team really well, or it's somebody with a venue, or just an idea of, you know, those fan ideas of we'd love to see this kind of show. How can our audience get a hold of you?
Well, you can find me on Facebook under Entertainment Capital Group. You can find me on LinkedIn under Dwayne Davison. And then if you need my phone number, just reach out to Jason. He'll give it to you.
I got it. I'll get it to you. So we will get you the information. And nothing on the calendar right yet. I know you're working on a couple of things. But if everyone comes back, checks back in with Entertainment Capital Group in 3 to 4 months.
Give us a month or two.
Give us a month or two. So come back right before 4th of July. check out Entertainment Capital Group, and you should see a whole slew of events that are coming up. Some comedy stuff, some music stuff, and hopefully some comedy and music stuff together.
Yes, sir.
Because I'd love that. That's a show I want to go to. So, Dwayne, thank you so much for being here today.
Thanks.
We're
going
to have you back in a few minutes for our panel discussion. Get everybody talking back together. I'm Jason LeDuc. This is Geeks R Sexy. We'll be right back with Katie Watford.